12 questions you'd likely get asked in a Microsoft interview if you're applying for a program manager role. And by program manager, I'm including here, you know, including business program managers as well as operations program managers. Even if, you know, the nuancing might be slightly different. And I'm going to go through this list from the least commonly asked to the most commonly asked. But if you're just here for the list, it's also in the video description. So number 12, we have, how do you disagree with your manager? All right, so in my opinion, the most important thing here is you understand why they ask you this in the first place. And the simple one word answer for this is trust. Are you able to generate trust while working, you know, with someone? So you must prove your case here. You must talk about such experience, a behavioral interview, essentially. Number 11, what areas do you want to be better in? So this is a synonym with what's your weakness, actually. If, for example, for a software development engineer, they would simply ask you, hey, what's your weakness? Notice here that the nuancing is quite different given the type of role that you're applying for. Program manager, what areas do you want to be better in? You want to improve here. And maybe one quick note here, when you're preparing the weakness, ensure that you also know pretty well what's your strength. Not because you're going to get asked, but more because you want to advertise in your strengths throughout a job interview. Number 10, tell me about the time when you persuaded senior management of an idea and what was the outcome. Personally, I'm an adept of positivity in job interviews, so unless you have an extraordinary example of a time when you failed to persuade them to do something, I would always talk about the success. As with the first question, with a time when you disagree with your manager, this one is also when you persuade someone of something, you must earn their trust first. So it's also because of this that this question gets asked. Number 9, tell me about the time when you had to deal with a difficult team member. Question about generating trust working in a team. So this is, you know, as an exercise, you must think what's a good example that you'd want to communicate in your job interview. Number 8, what's your favorite product or program, you know, if you're not working with products, as well as, you know, what's your favorite Microsoft product, if this is the case. So you must think, what's something you would feel like it's your strength, you would very much enjoy talking about in a job interview, and that could be, as the question implies, the product or the program. So this is also another one that I find very useful for training purposes, especially. Number 7, what was a project that you worked on and how was it impactful? What did you do on it? Project, you know, it could be a technical, it could be a business, it could be any type of project that relates to the type of work that you're doing and the role that you're applying for. The idea is that you want to showcase how you created value within this context. And I believe a synonym question to this, and actually a better question if you want, would be, what's your most successful project? But because of the seniority of and the implications of the role, the expectations of the role, the questions are always framed slightly counterintuitive. So it will rarely be obvious as to why they ask you these questions. How have you worked through ambiguity in the past? So dealing with ambiguity is a pretty standard topic in behavioral interviews. And this is basically, you know, where you must find that one event in your career, that one significant event where you navigated ambiguity successfully. Number 4, tell me about the time when you had to align interests of multiple stakeholders to achieve a goal. So your negotiation, your communication, your ability to build trust inside a working environment. Number 3, describe a time when you made a critical error. So this is another misleading question. It's actually, tell me about the time when you failed. It's just exposed in a slightly different way. And notice here carefully, a time when you made a critical error. So this is another way, by mentioning the word critical, that you will be significantly constrained as to what experience will you feel the most comfortable talking about. And if you haven't prepared this in advance, chances are that here you will slightly block during the interview, especially because of the type of the way this question was worded, a critical error, not just an error, right? So when you make an error, it's an error during this interview. So it's a failure question, and there could be other framings as well for these types of questions. For example, discuss about the wrong decision that you took in your previous roles. Right, so critical error, it's a more general type of question, but it could be even more specific, like with the wrong decision, right? So these failures can be framed in many flavors, and I would strongly suggest you prepare more than one, at least three, if you ask me, for a strong behavioral interview. So if you expect this interview to be a behavioral one, as it is often being reported to be the case, then in my opinion, you should go with at least three of these failures. I also have plenty of other videos on failure stories if you want to learn more. And number two, talk about your past project experiences. So this is a synonym to tell me about yourself. Needless to say, tell me about yourself is your could be the first question into pretty much any round of interview, being a phone screen or a now virtual on-site. So tell me about yourself. I believe it should go without saying you should prepare it, but again, it comes in many different flavors. Last but not least, the most commonly asked question, as to my knowledge, is why Microsoft? And I've just done a video about how do you go about answering why Microsoft, but just shortly, you know, you must talk about your personal qualities that, you know, had made a difference for you in your career. What do you bring to the table? You know, why do you think you're the best candidate for the role? You must also praise a little bit Microsoft if you feel like so appropriate. And you must also talk about your roadmap. What's in for you? Where do you see yourself 5 years from now? So this would be, you know, the 12 questions that I believe are worth preparing for, you know, of course, as an exercise going into a primarily behavioral but non-technical interview with Microsoft.